This is Thomas Lyons of Raps on TV, down here at Old Bailey. Fortunate to be joined by AY, Anthony Yarde, you know, stamina for sale.
Lyons in the camp.
Firstly, Anthony, how you been?
I've been very, very good. Again, just come off of another victory, a knockout victory. I feel blessed, I feel happy. Things are progressing in a, you know, a very profuse manner. And I'm happy.
Yeah, just talk to me about how the kind of performance went for you on the night down at Royal Albert Hall, the way you systematically broke down Travis Rees, a game opponent on paper, and kind of did give you that kind of experience. Yes. In this kind of part of your career. Just how happy were you with your performance on the night?
Again, you said it. I'd done my job. I systematically broke down my opponent, and that's what I wanted to do. And that's what I said I was going to do. I feel like... what I wanted again was one of them, the highlights. You know, you get the good highlight reel. But at the same time, the objective is to get the win the best way possible. And again, I always try to get the win in the knockout form. I go in there with an aim of to break down my opponent and stop him.
Yeah.
This time I've done it within 5 rounds. Travis Rees was no pushover. Again, previously football world title, Morak took him. He took Morak 12 rounds, lost on the decision. But he's been in there with some good opposition, and again, he comes to fight.
Yeah.
And he had, if you go and look at all the interviews he was in, he genuinely believed in himself. And again, he knew that if he got past me, he was going to be put in a fantastic position.
Yeah.
So he came to win. He told me after the fight again, because I wasn't coming here as a number, I came here to win. And he goes, you're the truth. He kept saying it over and over again. He goes, you're the truth, man. He goes, I've never been in there with anyone like you.
Yeah.
Again, these are things that I always take into consideration. But I think it was a fantastic win for me.
Yeah.
Hardly got hit. The only mark I got on me was that was from his hair.
Yeah.
When he was on the inside, and the referee said, "Chavez, mind your head." But other than that, look, hardly got hit.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't really get hit. Only a couple of jabs. We were both jabbing at the same time. Progression.
Yeah, and it was kind of such a clinical performance. And obviously, now that you're kind of the face of BT Sport,
yes.
I know that you keep a very kind of humble and reserved kind
yes.
of, you know, your confidence comes in the ring when you kind of perform
yes.
and, you know, you showcase the skills that you've had. Not a lot of amateur experience being well documented. You
yes.
haven't had a lot of fights as a professional.
Yes.
But to see your progress kind of since your pro debut right to now,
yes.
and now kind of making that transition phase into world level contention, just how pleased are you with the way you've stepped up?
How I feel and how pleased I am is beyond words. And again, where you come from, where I've come from, again, I have to talk about this. I have to talk about the foundation that Mark Prince has started up. Where you come from, this kind of community, where I've seen people get stabbed, I've seen people die, stabbed and died. I've seen people get shot. I've seen gang robberies. I've been in a situation myself where I could have lost my life several times. And I see it as now I've got opportunity. I saw it like this from when I was 19 years old. I've still got opportunity. And again, one of the things that forced me to go into the boxing and stop making excuses, because I went down the road of playing football, things not going well, me breaking my toe, getting charged for QPR, getting an injury during the trial game, after they already said, yeah, we want you. Athletics, breaking my toe in athletics. After going down all these roads, I could have made excuses.
Yeah.
Being from the area I'm from, and again, I will always say this, I did make excuses when it first happened. I come back, tried to do some more training, got another injury. I said, this ain't like, I've tried my best. It wasn't really my best, but I tried my best, like, things ain't going well for me. I started making all these excuses. One of my friends that were doing bad things, I contacted him, I said, put me on.
Yeah.
Don't not put me on. Introduce me to the right contacts, we're gonna make things happen, etc. And then after all these kind of things happen, and my friend, he's my brother, because he said to me, no. You're better than that.
Yeah.
Like, I know, I see big things happening for you. I'm not introducing to these gangbangers I know or these bad people I know. You're better than that. Like, and then my boy's got tattoos all over him. Now he's an accountant.
Yeah.
And he said that I motivated him, because after he turned me down, I went to another person I knew, and I'd done bad things, and I realized very shortly that wasn't my destiny. And I made the decision to go and do good things. He said I motivated him. He stopped doing what he was doing. Went through, I had a conversation with him about sacrifice. Everything you're doing right now, is an easy way out because you're not willing to sacrifice, go through a bit of like bad times,
yeah.
be broke for a bit, go through that, maybe breaking up with your partner, maybe losing some family members due to not being able to, I'm just using examples, pay them back some money, or you might lose family members because they're stressed out, you can't spend time with your nieces and nephews, so they think you don't care. Sacrifice something. My boy, when he sacrificed, it must be that 6 years of his life, yeah? No one saw him. He's still one of my close friends, but no one saw him. When I done all these exams,
yeah.
My man's an accountant now.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Another one of my friends, similar storyline. He didn't do as much bad things, but again, he's an accountant.
Yeah.
Two of my friends that I grew up with, that lived in the same kind of environment as me, are accountants. So I've got people that are now business owners around me. One of my friends, he's got a foundation with Box Up Crime. He used to be into food and all these other bad things. Now he's got his own organization.
Yeah.
I'm a boxer, number one ranked by the WBO. And these are people that I've kept around me because they're like-minded. You know what I'm saying? So I'm always going to try and be an inspiration to these young kids. Mark Prinsen was made me cry today.
Yeah.
Because what he was saying was so good. He made the decision that showed his character. He sacrificed his own emotion, which is the hardest thing to do, is deal with your own emotion.
Yeah.
Emotion is when someone gets angry and they can't control it, that's emotion. When someone retaliates, that's emotion. He said it up on the stage. Initially, he wanted to kill the people, which is an obvious response to everyone. Your emotion, your initial emotion is anger, fear. You want to now go in and pain on these people because they've taken away something from you. They took away his son. But he was allowed, he had a right to feel like that. But what determined his character was his response and how he dealt with it, not his feats, not what he was thinking at the time of anger. What he's now going to be remembered for and why he's going to be a legend in my eyes always, he made a decision to go and be positive. Now he's affecting and changing thousands, on maybe hundreds of thousands, maybe even millions of kids' lives. He changed my life.
Yeah.
Just from speaking to him.
Yeah.
He still inspires me till today. You know what I'm saying? So when you got a person like that that's got such strong character, such a good heart, you can only create things like this.
Yeah, and with the kind of whole grassroots initiative that he's kind of portrayed and the success he's had with it, has there been kind of periods in your life where you kind of have had to channel that aggression, those emotions that you talked about? And how important is boxing as just a form of martial arts, but kind of a more a broad message? How important is it to instill discipline into young people?
It's 100%. The importance of it is 100%. And as I was saying to you before, control of emotion, that's something I learned to do over the years. When I was younger, I had a very bad temper. And this, I don't hide it from anybody. When I was younger, I had a very bad temper. Yeah? A lot of my temper was to do with excuses.
Yeah.
I used to feel like that's my excuse. This is how I'm going to release my anger. I'm just going to lose my temper.
Yeah.
And whatever happens within me, lose my temper, happens. And then when I got to that, when I come out of the teenage years, because when you're a teenager, you can make up decisions as you want. I don't care, man, I don't care, I'm losing my temper. No one can control me when I lose my temper. I look back at that now and say, that was a lost kid that made excuses. Now, again, I'm still working, not on my temper, because again, I've better control over my emotion, but I'm still working on other aspects of life. Learning, listen to this scenario. I'm still learning how to channel my good heart. So make better decisions for myself based on my good heart. And what I mean by that is, I've made mistakes in the past year by having a good heart. So I've allowed the wrong people around me, same for my mum did, I've allowed the wrong people around me whose sole purpose is to bring me down. I've let people manipulate me. I've let people manipulate me and guilt trip me due to my good heart. When in the long run, their goal or their outcome was not good for me. So I've had to learn to channel that as well, my good heart as well as my past of being aggressive and things like that. I've had to start to say, Anthony, be selfish. Be selfish for the people that you do love.
Yeah.
You can't be around anybody, you can't help everybody. If someone's threatening you with something about guilt tripping you, or they're threatening you with certain things, that's what they're gonna do.
Yeah.
It's sad, but that's what they're gonna do. Don't let them now determine your movements.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because they can bring you down. You know what I'm saying? So It's all in progression.
Yeah, just a quick one. Obviously, it's been well documented. Number one position now with the WBO.
Come on.
Sergei Kovalev, the champion. Fair to say he's on kind of the his kind of back end of his career.
Yes.
And you're obviously young, fresh, considered contender now, kind of coming up. So, I mean, is that what's in the pipeline next? I mean, I know you'll sit down with your team, Frank Moore of BT Sport, but is that the fight you want next?
Well, that's been mandated. Right now, that's the fight I want.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you. It's being negotiated as we speak. Hopefully, the fight comes to fruition. It happens. I will go and win the fight by knockout. I'm not going to hide that. I will go and win the fight by knockout. Hopefully, it happens. Again, people talk about me shying away from challenges and things like that. This fight, again, fights like this are going to change my life. This is the reason I got into this sport. So, with people with their silly comments about, oh, he's not fighting this person, he's not fighting that person, I'm here. I'm here.
Yeah.
And I'm in a position where I can change my life.
Yeah.
So, hopefully, it happens. If it don't, I'm going to continue with my journey. And it, eventually, people are going to see what's going to happen with my life. My life's changing already. It's going to continue to change. And the inspiration I'm going to have within myself and what I do is going to change a nation.
Yeah, Anthony, appreciate you giving me some of your time today, getting you on the platform, and I do wish you all the best with 2019 and your future endeavours. To see you down here supporting such a wonderful cause as well, it's a testament to your character.
Love, my brother.
Thomas Lyons, Raps on TV.
Raps Anthony on TV. Lyons in the
top man.